And today we're going to meet my personal doll army. This little plushy doll is Drew. I think she's inspired, I'm pretty sure she's inspired by Drusilla from Buffy the Vampire Slayer. She was made by a wonderful artist named Anne Larimer, whom I have known for years and years from various fandoms. I love her little bat stockings, they're so cute. But my friend Jenny actually got her for me from the art show at Media West several years ago, probably about 10 years ago. And I love her. I love her little, her big blue eyes and her mysterious veil. This is Mother Denmark. She was brought by our exchange student when I was a junior in high school. Hi, Ricky. And this little German lady was brought by an exchange student who lived with my family when I was in college, Stefan, and I only met him briefly, but he brought me this pretty lady. As you can see, it's a very eclectic army. I've never been much for getting a complete set of any particular kind of doll. I just get dolls that I love. So let's move on. These shelves are where Tallulah and Miss Edith live. And at the moment they have their little maypole situation going on, and Lady McWombat is helping them out with their maypole because it's May and it's spring and there are flowers and oh, we are so happy. Tallulah and Miss Edith are the dolls that I am most likely to change their outfits, change their little tableau, and it's just fun to set up little scenes with them. A lot of times I'll include them in the Wombat Friday pictures with Lady McWombat. Tallulah here, I got her for Christmas, I think it was for Christmas, when I was 7, and my cousin Jenny got an identical one. She's about a year younger than I am, and her original dress is brown, and she came with a little brown straw cloche hat, and I've got both of those tucked away. She's in her little green outfit right now for the spring. I see her dolls that look just like her a lot in thrift stores and antique stores and things. I think there must have been a huge number of them made in the late 70s, and I sort of feel like a whole generation is tied together by this doll, which is kind of fun. She's a bisque porcelain doll with painted eyes. Tallulah is named Tallulah because the way she was packaged in her box, her little brown cloche hat had a little kink in the crease in the brim, so it kind of folded over. And around that time, the movie Bugsy Malone came out. It was this weird, weird movie that had all of these kids playing adult roles in this like 30s gangster movie. And Jodie Foster played this gangster's moll who was a nightclub singer. When I got this doll out and she had the little cloche hat with the little kink in the brim, it made me think of that. And so I named her Tallulah. Miss Edith, bless her, as you can probably see, is missing an eye. She came off of the clearance shelf at, I think, Michael's, around the time that I was doing a lot of cons cosplaying as Drusilla from Buffy the Vampire Slayer. And of course, Miss Edith was her doll that she put the eyes out of at one point because Drew was not always a kind mommy to her dollies. And so I'd carry her around. She actually has an outfit that is a copy of one of Drusilla's outfits, which is a black chiffon dress with the long angel sleeves. And I was carrying her at a con once, and James Marsters looked at her and said, "I know that dress," which was great fun. So Spike recognized Miss Edith. Now, of course, my Miss Edith has auburn hair, and Drusilla's Miss Edith was blonde. But I really, you know, when I rescued her with her little missing eye, I really couldn't name her anything else. And I don't cosplay Drew anymore, and I suppose it's kind of creepy to put the spotlight on this porcelain doll, this poor doll with one eye. The funny thing is nobody ever says anything about it. They're just like, "Oh, she's so pretty. Oh, isn't that cute?" And they're like not sure what to say. Her hair has gotten kind of bonkers over the years. I keep thinking I need to get her a new wig. I should probably get her a new wig. And also, poor to poor Tallulah, her hair has never been that great because it was swished down in the with the hat, and she was not, you know, she was never a high-end doll. She was very much a mass market doll made for little girls in the 70s to have porcelain dolls. But I love her. These ladies up here on the top shelf are some of my fancier collector dolls. They're porcelain, and we'll start with Lady Diana, Princess Diana Bride doll, who was made by, is it Danbury Mint or Franklin Mint? I can't remember now. I think it was the Franklin Mint. 1986, she was the first major purchase I made with my own money from my waitress job. I love her dress. They detailed it really well. Her train and her veil are actually to scale, so they're like 6 feet long. Piled up, it's kind of like what she looked like in the carriage going to the wedding, with the train and the veil, all that just completely filling the carriage. Noni here was missing in the box for over 10 years, and besides Rita Jane and Pocahontas, she was the one that made me the saddest to be missing, because she's the one, my mom went to a craft fair while I was away at school my freshman year of college, and she had seen the lady who had made these porcelain dolls, and she said, oh, I should get one for Val, but she didn't see one that she really, really wanted for me, and the lady said, oh, I'll do one custom for you, and she's just beautiful. She has some beautiful under things as well. I've just steamed her dress and her petticoat. She's got a pretty little chemise and pantalettes. Bonnie Blue and Cosette, neither of them is officially those characters, but you can see why I named them that. Bonnie, I think, came from Joanne Fabrics, of all things, and that was, you know, probably about 15 years ago. They were making some really pretty little 15-inch porcelain dolls that had really nice, pretty, well-made outfits. You just don't, you know, the ones that you see now, they've got like, stuff is all hot glued on them and they're just terrible. But these still had, this is when they were still making them out of some fairly nice fabrics and pretty lace and, you know, fabrics that were appropriate to the size. And so I really like her, and she's got such pretty hair, and she's got such a cute face.